Here we'll show you how to change the firmware of Magic Home LED strips and similar products so you can run them free from the cloud and pair with Home Assistant. Magic Home LED strips are using BL602 Wi-Fi module, which we have already flashed once in our previous video about Son of Bulb. Please watch it if you haven't seen it yet. Our Magic Home LED strips is an RGB version, but there is also other versions which can be programmed in similar way. Let's start by removing plastic case. Just pry it with screwdriver. There are no screws. It's very easy. Here is the board. You can already see the BL602 microcontroller and the pads used for programming. Like before, we will need to solder 5 wires. Ground, 3.3V, RX, TX and boot. You can also see the IR pad, which is used for IR receiver on some models. Thanks to our firmware, you can repurpose it for any other role, for example, use it to connect a button. First, add some flags on the pads. It will make soldering easier. Do not attempt soldering without flags. Then tin the pads. You can see that tinning the ground pad is a bit harder because it's on a ground plane and can dissipate much more heat than other pads, but it is still possible. Then tin your wires and now you can finally solder them one by one. Soldering ground wire is a bit harder, but we just need a temporary connection. Solder remaining wires. Do not move away the wire. First, wait to solder to solidify. Remember that you can solder those wires even with the cheapest soldering iron. It just requires some practice, and you also should make sure that soldering iron tip is always clean. Now all wires are soldered. It's time to finish the programming circuit. We will use a different method than before. In this case, you can just use 10K resistor between 3.3V and boot signal. Connect only ground, RX and TX to USB to UART converter and power the controller from the DC power supply. Just make sure your power supply polarity is correct. Also make sure that you connect the resistor first and then repower the device. The boot signal must be pulled high at reboot to activate the bootloader. On your PC, just like before, use BLDevCube to flash open BL602 binary. Links are in the video description. After flashing is successful, disconnect the boot resistor and power cycle the device. The access point should appear. Now do the basic configuration just like in our previous Son of Bulb video. Connect to device access point, open configuration, set your Wi-Fi SSID and password and reboot it. You can already set up MQTT data at this point if you want. You can get the new device IP from your router DHCP page. Finally, it's time to configure the I/O roles for the device. This is an RGB strip, so it needs 3 PWM outputs to control the LEDs. Use our online templates database to figure out which I/Os are used. If template is not present, then you need to use the BL602 datasheet and analyze the track on PCB. In this case, you need to set PWM roles for P4, P3 and P21 with channels in that order. First channel is red, second is green, third is blue. Once the device is configured, you can also do automatic Home Assistant discovery, but we already have a video about that. See the playlist on our channel. Don't forget to desolder the wires after you make sure that everything is working. BL602 platform already supports updates over the Wi-Fi. Okay, it's time for the final test. As you can see, the RGB controls are working. You can select colors with HTML color picker, control the strip brightness level, and turn it on and off. The same controls will be added to Home Assistant when you do an automatic discovery. Thank you for watching. If you have any question, please visit our forum. Remember that you can also submit a device teardown and template to our forum and get a free gift. See details in the video description. See you on Electroda!